وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرِ.
السلام علیکم ورحمت اللہ وبرکاتہ. رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری وحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہ قولی. Welcome back, dear brothers and sisters. I welcome you all to Madina Book 3. Inshallah, we'll be doing our class 51 today. So again, continuing our lesson number 15, inshallah, we'll be doing exercises from lesson number 15. So this is a very interesting part. It's a very long lesson, but as Dr. Abdul Rahim mentioned, so whoever learns this lesson, he has learned like many lessons. So we'll take it slowly and we'll try and cover all the exercises, inshallah. So going forward, في كل فقرة مما يأتي جملتان. So in each passage that follows, that which follows, مما يأتي جملتان, there are two sentences. اجعل, so make. اجعل, make. فعل الأولى, فعل الأولى شرطا وفعل الأخرى جوابه. So we have to make the first one as a فعل شرط, and the second one we have to make a جواب شرط. Musta'amilan. So what fa'al is this? What word is this? Musta'amilan is, it is a masdar for form 10. Whenever you see seen and ta, as if seen and ta, it's a form 10. So using. So it's a very common word in Urdu. It's called istama'al. So it comes from the Arabic word ista'amala. So musta'amilan. Adat ash-shart. Al-mazkurata bain al-qawsaini. So the instrument of shart that is mentioned, mazkuratan zakara yazkuru. Mazkuratan is your ism maf'ul, that which is mentioned bain al-qawsaini, between the brackets. So there we go. So we have two sentences here. So one and two, and we have two fa'ils. So we have to make the first one as a shart, and second as a jawab shart, using this adat shart mentioned in the bracket. So let's go to the first one. يغيب أكثر من أسبوعين يفصلوا. So we know when we bring man, which is اسم شرط جازم تجزم فعلين, what happens to يغيب? So it makes it مجزوم. So this comes from غاب يغيب. It is أجوف أل يائي. So whenever we know there is أجوف, what happens when it becomes مجزوم? The weak letter is dropped. So what happens? It becomes مي يغيب. Aksara, whoever is absent. So man, we will translate as whosoever. So whosoever is absent. Aksara min. So aksara is coming as a mafoolun bihi, and we know it's coming as a ismu taftil. So whoever is absent more than usbu'aini. Usbu'aini is 2 weeks. Usbu'ani is 2 weeks. Marfu. And usbu'aini. Usbu'aini is here. Ism majroor. So man aksara yaghib. Aksara min usbu'aini yufsalu, that is your majhul, and it becomes yufsal, he will be removed. So how do we write? I said man yaghib aksara min usbu'aini yufsal. So we know where the shart starts and where the jawab shart starts, alhamdulillah. So let's go to another example. Ta'kulu akulu. So if somebody offers you what you want to eat, so how do you reply? So you say, and you have to use this ma again, ismu shart jazimun tajzimu fi'alaini. So it makes the two fa'al majzoom. So you've got two fa'al. How do you make it? So ma ta'akul akul. So whatever you eat, takununa. So kana yakunu. So we know it will have, it is naqis, it will have ism and khabar. So here, what is the ism? Waw is your ism representing antum. Takununa. Noon is a sign of marfu. Azurukum. So zara yazuru. This azuru is I visit. You kum is your mafoolun bihi. Insha'Allah. That's again, it's a conditional sentence. We'll do it later, inshallah. So if you want to make majzum using this adatu shart, aina ma, we know it is aina is wherever, ma is for tawqeed, to emphasize. So aina ma takunu. So we make it majzumun bi hazafinun. Aina ma takunu azurkum. So you make it majzum azurkum. So I will visit you, inshallah. So wherever you be, I will visit you. La yarhamu, la yurhamu. So we need to understand what type of la is this. So if it was la nahiya, so we would have heard majzum. So it's not la nah, it is la nafiya. So we know la nafiya, la mahalla lahu fil i'rab. So it doesn't make anything marfu, doesn't change anything the following noun. So it just remains silent. So but when we bring your ismu shart, whatever happens to the fa'al is not because of la, it is because of the ismu shart. So we need to remember, even in coming sentences, sometimes it can be confusing. So we need to bear this in mind, inshallah. So how do we do this? Rahima, yarhamu is to be kind or to be merciful. So one who is not, does not show mercy. So how do we say? Man la yarham. So whoever does not show mercy, la yurham. So he will be not shown mercy. Yurham again is your fa'al majhul. So how would we do it in the majhul form? The madi will be ruhima yurhamu. So if you are making it as a jawab ushar, it will be la yurham. Ta'udu, a'ud. So aada ya'udu is to return. So we have to use mata again, using as a ismu shart. Jazimun tajzimu fi'alaini, making the both the fa'ils majzum. One will be shart, another will be jawab shart. So again we know, we are ajwaf, ajwaf al-wawi. What happens when it becomes majzum? The weak letter is dropped. So it would be mata ta'ud, a'ud. Mata ta'ud, a'ud. Whenever you return, I return. Number 6. Tajlisu, ajlisu. It's most common between friends when they go to class. Where you want to sit, is it? If you have to use aina, so you say aina tajlis, ajlis. Wherever you sit, I sit. So this is a straightforward. So but that's what we need to remember. So these are all coming as a ismu shart, jazimun tajzimu fi'alaini. Taqra'u, aqra'u. So again, same thing, very simple. So mahma, so we know it means whatever. So whatever. So how do we say? So you have to make majzum, just change the dhamma into sukoon. It will be mahma taqra, aqra. So whatever you read, I read. Yatubu ilallahi. Yatubu alayhi Allahu. So it is a very beautiful way of telling me, but we need to understand this expression here. So taba yatubu, it is again ajwaf al-wawi, but the meaning of taba yatubu changes when we use different prepositions. So we see here, we got taba ila and we have ala. So taba ila is a slave asking repentance to, that is, he's repented to. So repented to, so there's a typo error here, it shouldn't have been n, so he's a repented to. So whereas taba'ala is when a master accepts his repentance and he turns towards him. So he returns to. So that is what the ala harf chair makes the whole difference. So whichever the harf chair is coming, so that will change the meaning of this fa'al taba. So here taba'ala is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is accepting the repentance and he is returning, he's turning towards the slave. So if we translate this, yatubu ilallahi, so he is repenting to Allah, yatubu alayhi allahu. So where is the file here? The file is Allahu lafzul jalala. So Allah returns towards him. So if we want to use man, ismu shartun jazimun tajzimu fi'alaini, so we have to make both these fa'ils majzum and see how it is translated. So we say man yatub. So man yatub, but because of the tajweed rules, we will say man yatub. So we know the waw is dropped here. So whosoever yatub ilallahi, ilallahi, to repents to Allah, yatub alayhi Allahu or yatubillahu alayhi. So Allah will return or he will turn towards him. Yushriku billahi. So again, it's a very simple one. So you have to use man. So if you do it by yourself, I'll give you a few seconds. That's good. So here we need to see that the fa'al if there is no al following it, so we can pronounce it as normal majzoom forms will be may yushrik billahi, whosoever associate partners with Allah. Ashraka yushriku is a form 4, so we need to go to the root of the words, so which form it is from. So ashraka, so whenever we see you, we need to say it is a mazid fihi, and then we need to get the proper form from there. So ashraka yushriku form 4, and it comes most of the time with harf jar b, associating partners with. So whosoever associate partners with Allah, yadkhul. See, yadkhul. So why do we have kasra? That is for the phonetics reason. So yadkhulin nara, so he will enter the fire. Yanjahu, yanjahu is to be successful or to pass. Bitaqdirin mumtazin, with excellent grades. Yahsulu ala jaizatin. So hasala yahsulu is to acquire or to get. So it always comes with harf jar ala. So if you want to use man, so you say man yanjah, just make it majzoom. Bitaqdiri mumtazin, with excellent grade. Yahsul. So we need to understand the jawabu shart. So where the shart ends and the consequence starts. So the consequence is, as a consequence of passing an excellent grade, so yahsul. So he gets. So always comes with the ala. So the following noun will be ism majroor. So he will get a reward. Jaizatun. Jaza yajuzu. So now we are coming to see the interjection of fa. So Dr. Abdurrahim says, عرفت في الدرس السابق أن جواب الشرط يقترن بالفاء في مواضع منها. So you know, in the lesson which is just passed, in the previous lesson, أن. So we need to know if this is أن or أن. So we need to see if there is a فعل or a noun. So here we got a noun, جواب. جوابٌ will become جواب اسم أن. So that the جواب الشرط يَقْتَرِنُ اِقْتَرَنَ يَقْتَرِنُ. See, that is the form 8. So, to be connected. So, we know that the jawab al-shart is connected بِالْفَاءِ with fa fi مَوَادِيَ مِنْهَا in the following conditions. We're going to listen to the song by Brother Asif for us to recollect and remember where the fa enters. Inshallah, just listen to it and then we'll go to the examples of Dr. Abdurrahim.
اسمية طلبية اسمية طلبية وبجامد وبجامد اسمية طلبية وبجامد وبجامد وبما ولن وبقد وبتنفيس وبما ولن وبقد وبتنفيس اسمية طلبية وبجامد Wabi jamid. I'll sing one more time, brother and sister. You'll get used to it, huh? Ismiyatun talabiyatun wabi jamid. Wabi jamid. Wabi mawalan. Wabi kad. Wabi tanfis. Wabi mawalan. Wabi kad. Wabi tanfis. Ismiyatun talabiyatun. Wabi jamid. Wabi jamid. Ismiyatun talabiyatun. Wabi jamid. Wabi jamid. I hope you liked it.
So I hope you have all memorized this song. So inshallah, which help us to remember when the fa will enter a jawabu shart. So how do we say? We say al fa'u waqi'atu lit jawabi shart. So let's take some examples. So Dr. Ibrahim brings here. So first one is an yakuna jumlatan ismiyatan. So if, and the second one, it says an yakuna fa'alan talabiyan. So we know talabiyan is wa min anwa'u talabi. So what is the types of talab we know? Is al-amr wal nahi wal istifham. So in amr we have fa'al amr and lamu amr. So all these things, it will form the talab. So naskur al-an baqiyat al-mawadiya. So we're going to mention the rest of the examples or rest of the types. An yakuna fa'alan jamidan. So what is jamid? Jamid is the fa'al which is only in the madi. So there is no mudara, there is no amr. So it is laisa and asa. So at the moment we're just doing laisa. So it's a very beautiful hadith of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam where he says, man ghashana. So what is ghasha? Ya ghushu is to cheat. Is to cheat. So here ghashana is, it is fa'al madi. So that's why we don't see a sign of manjzum. So it will be mabniyun ala fatha fi mahalli jasbin, and na is your maf'ulun bihi. So whosoever cheats us, this is how we translate. So na here, it means us, means to, or to the Muslim. So whosoever cheats the Muslim, falaysa minna. So why do we have fa here? Because alfa waqiyatul jawab shart, because it is a jamid. Falaysa minna. So minna is, he is not from us. Again, we need to understand there are two words in this, min plus na. It is damir muttasil majroor. So whosoever cheats us, he is not from us. So again, when does the fa enter? An yaktarina bi qad. So whenever it is connected with qad. So we know qad comes in jumlatul fa'liya. So always there is a fa'al which comes after the qad. What is qad? Qad is harfu tahqiq, for the emphasis, for the that if it is followed with the madi, normally it means the job has been done. And when it comes in jumlatul shartiya, that means it's something which is certain. So it gives the expression of certainty. So وَمَنْ يُتِعْ. So again, see, يُتِعْ. So why do we have you here? Because it is, what form is this? أَطَاءَ يُتِيءُ. It will be form 4. So what happens when it becomes majzoom? The weak letter is dropped. So يُتِيءُ will become يُتِعْ. So whosoever, أَطَاءَ is to obey. Is to obey or is to follow Allah. So whosoever follows Allah wa rasulahu. See, wa rasulah is ma'tufun ala Allah, lafzul jalala. So whoever follows Allah and his messenger rasulahu, faqad fa alwaqiyatu li jawab ash-shart. And why it is occurring? Because of qad. So he is indeed faza fawzan aziman. So very beautiful way. So it's faza yafuzu, again ajwaf alwawi, to be successful. So what type of success is the fawzan that is coming as mafoolun mutlaq? It is a master from the fa'al which is used in the sentence. And aziman is your nat. So indeed he has achieved a great success. Wa man yuti Allah wa rasulahu faqad faza fawzan aziman. So where else the fa will come? An yaqtarina bil ma'an nafiya. So you know ma performs different functions. So one is your harf nafi, and it can be ismu istifham, and here it will be ismu shart, and it can also come as jawab shart, but it will be in normal and as a nafiya. So mahma takun az-zuruf fama akzib. So we need to understand here. So mahma is whatever. So takun, we know kana yakunu, it is your naqis fa'al. Looking for ism kana. So where is ism here? We have to look for the noun which is marfu. So what is marfu here? Zuruf. What is zuruf? Zuruf is the, here it means condition. So whatever be the condition. So mahma takun, why do we have takun here? Zuruf is a kullu jama' mu'annas. So we need to relate everything, inshallah, and understand properly. So whatever be the condition, fama aksib. So why ma is your harf nafi, is negating. So ma akzibu, So it remains marfu. So we know harf nafi will not have any effect on the fa'al. So it remains marfu. So I will not lie. So an yaqtarina bilan. So we know whenever there is a lan, again it is harf nafi fil mustaqbal. Harf nafi fil mustaqbal for futurity. So now, so again this is a very beautiful hadith. It is related to man here. Man labisal harira. So labisa yalbasu is to adorn or to wear. So whoever adorns himself or wears harira is the silk. So it is relating to men. It's not about women. Fid dunya. So whoever wears the silk in dunya, falan yalbasahu. So we know lan, it is harfu nasbin wa nafin fil mustaqbal. So it makes the fa'al mansub, like we did in the previous class. Lan aghiba ba'da hada. So lan aghiba mansub. So lan will make a fa'al mansub. So he says falan yalbasa. So who is your mafulun? So falan yalbasahu fil akhirah. So whosoever harira, the silk in this dunya, he will not wear it in the akhirah. So ay yaqtarina bi bisin. So we know seen and saufa is your tanfis. It's but again it is about futurity, what it is in and positive that it will be done. So lan is will not be done, say will be done. So for example, in to safir, if you travel, in, you know, harfu shart, it's not ism, harfu shart, jazimun tajzimu fi alaini. So if you travel, so again sa and safa will not have any effect on the fa'al. So it will remain marfu. Fa sa usafiru. So why fa is come? Because the seen. So we need to remember this. We have to put fa whenever we have these seven conditions, what Brother Asif is mentioned in his song, if you want to remember. Ayn yaqtarina bi sawfa. So again, it is tanfis. So obviously, again, bringing an ayah from the Quran, from Tawbah. Wa in khiftum aylatan fa sawfa yughniikum Allahu min fadlihi insha'a. So there's a typo here actually. It's not in, because if it was in, we should have it down. So these are the things which we actually have to pick up. You know, sometimes there can be typo errors. So in, which is followed by, it is in, sha'a, it is a harfu shart, jazimun tajzimu fi ilayni actually. So let's see what it means here. In, we need to know it is harfu shart, jazimun tajzimu fi ilayni. So khiftum, which is khafa, it is to be afraid. So khiftum is fa'al madi, mabniun ala sukoon, fa'il is your tum. So if you are afraid, aylatan, what is aylatan? Is of poverty. Is poverty. If you are afraid of poverty, Allah is reassuring the Muslims, fa saufa, that he will yughniikum Allahu. Aghna yughni is to make someone make someone rich. So here Allah is telling, I will make you rich, min fadlihi, with his grace, insha'a, if he wills. So what we're looking here, we're looking for fa. Why fa is centered? Waqaytu li jawab shart, because of sawfa. Wa in khiftum aylatan fa sawfa yughniikum Allahu min fadlihi insha'a. Just remember, it's not inna, it's insha'a. Number 9, أَنْ يُسَدَّرَ بِكَأَنَّ مَنَحُ. So what this means, أَنْ يُسَدَّرَ, again it is, you see, أَنْ plus يُسَدَّرَ فَأَلْ مُدْوَارِيَ مَنْصُوب. سَدَّرَ يُسَدِّرُ is form 2. It is الْمَسْتَرْ مُعَوَّل. What does it mean? It's to come in front. So كَأَنَّمَ comes in front of the جَوَابُ الشَّرْ, then fa will come. So what is ka'anna? So you know, inna anna ka'anna layta lakinna la'alla. So these are the min akhwatu inna. So we're going to learn the expression ka'annama, innama later on, inshallah. So we're going to translate at the moment, which means as if or as though. So this is how we translate. So let's see the ayat here and see how the fa enters the sentence. It's from the Quran, Surah Ma'idah, verse 32.
أَنَّهُ مَنْ قَتَلَ نَفْسًا بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ أَوْ فَسَادٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَتَلَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا.
It's a very beautiful ayah which shows that especially very valid in current times. So what does Allah says about killing the innocent people? So what does it say here? Allah says, so annahu, truly he is, harf tawqid wa nasb, so it is for emphasis, for greater emphasis. So truly he, Allah says, man qatala, whosoever qatala, fa'al madi mabniun ala fatha fi mahalli jazmin, whosoever has killed, whosoever kills nafsan, a soul, bighayri nafsin. What is bighayri nafsin? Without for being a retaliation for a murder, or if a man has killed, so the punishment of him, if he's murdered, so he will be killed. If it is not for that purpose, aw fasadin, aw, or he has done a corruption in the land, he has done spread corruption, or he has done corruption, other than these two purposes, if anybody kills a soul, fil ardi, in the earth, faka'annama. So why is fa al-waqiyatu li jawabi shart? So jawabi shart is coming as with ka'annama. It is as if qatala an-nasa jami'an, as if he has killed the entire humanity, jami'an is for emphasis, in totality, the entire humanity. This is what how the Allah expresses with using the words. So we need to understand how severity of this sentence is. أَنَّهُ مَنْ قَتَلَ نَفْسًا بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ أَوْ فَسَادٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَتَلَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. So those are the conditions where the fa will enter. إِسْمِيَةٌ طَلَبِيَةٌ وَبِجَامِدْ وَبِمَا وَلَنْ وَبِقَدْ وَبِتَنْفِيسْ. So we just got to remember these things. So we know whenever the fa enters, we've been learning for a few lessons now, that we don't say the fa'al following fa is majzum, but it has to be fi mahalli jazmin, because it is not in its natural condition of jazm. So la yujzamu, so jawabu shart, so the jawabu shart is not made majzum, izaqtarana bilfa, if or when it is connected with fa. Wa yakunu al-i'rabu hina izin lil jumlati. So what does it mean here? That the i'rab will be thereupon upon the jumla. So whatever comes, so either it will be jumlatul fa'liyah or jumlatul ismiyah. So and we will say fa yuqalu innaha, and that jumla will be called, or it will be said, fi mahalli jazmin. So we already know this, inshallah, we should be comfortable with this now. So whenever there is a fa, the following things, what comes thereupon will be a jumla. And what type of jumla it will be, either it will be ismiya or failia, and we call it as a fi mahalli jazmin. So I hope it is clear, inshallah. Let's do some more example and have a practice of this fa. Adkhilil fa'a ala jawabi sharti fi jumlal. في جمل الآتية إذا كان ذلك واجبا واذكر سبب. So enter, so you have to enter the fa upon the jawab al-shart in the following sentences, and when it is necessary, so إذا كان واجبا, whenever it is necessary, so you have to enter the fa and you have to mention the sabab and why have you entered it. So we need to mention. It's very easy if you remember the song Man jadda wajada. So it's a famous proverb. So whosoever jadda. So what is jadda? It's fa'al madi mabniun ala fatha fi mahalli jazmin. So whosoever strives, so what happens to him? Wajada. So wajada again is fa'al madi. So do we bring fa if you have fa'al madi? So no, it doesn't fill the conditions. So only if the fa'al is talab, which is amr, nahi, or is the fam, so we bring fa. So here it is fa'al madi, so we don't need to bring fa. So man jadda wajada. So whosoever strives, he will gain, he will find the success. Da'a minni alfu riyalin. So what is da'a? Is to be lost. So what is the fa'al here? So we're looking for the marfu, that is alfu. So alfu is 1,000. Riyalin, 1,000 riyals is lost by me. This is how you would translate. So, or I lost 1,000 riyals. Fa. So, this fa is beginning of a new sentence. This is nothing to do with the shart or jawab or shart. So this fa tells us that it is related to the coming which is previous. So fa man yajidhu. See, man came, so here whosoever wajada yajidu. So misal, misal al wawi wajada yajidu. So yajid is your majzum. So whosoever finds it. So yajid who finds it. Wa ya'tini bihi. So we know ata ya'ti. So we need to look for the harf jar b. If it is b in the sentence, that means is to bring. The meaning changes from to come to bring. So whosoever finds it, yajidhu wa ya'tini bihi, and brings it to me. Ya'ti bihi nunun wiqaya mutakallim. It's again the mafulun bihi. Lahu ushratun. And for him, what is ushratun? It means 10%. So whosoever, so I lost 1,000 riyals. So whosoever finds it and brings it to me, so I will give him 10%, is 100 riyals. Mahma, so whatever. Yakun, again we know kana, yakunu, yakun. Sababu is your ismu kana. So whatever be the reason, sababu, ghiyabika. What is ghiyabun? Is your master from ghaba, yaghibu. So whatever is the answer for your absence. Qad fataka darsun muhimman. So do we have to enter? Yes. Why? Because there is qad. So what do we say? We have to say fa qad. Al-waqiyat al-jawab al-shart. And we say it is jumlat al-fa'liya. So we know qad always comes in jumlat al-fa'liya. So qad fataka. So again we know fata yafutu. Very interesting fa'il. In which the fa'il is the thing which has been missed. So here what is being missed? Darsun muhimun. Important lesson. So how do we translate? So whatever be your reason for your absence, you have indeed missed an important lesson. But later translation would be indeed an important lesson missed you. But that is not how we translate. We say, and you missed an important lesson. In takun majghulan. So if you are busy. Al-an, now. See, seen. Seen has come, which is tanfiz. Do we have to need fa? Yes, we need fa. So how do we say? We say fa sa'atika ghadan. So I will come to you. Ata ya'ti without harf jar b will be to come. So I will come to you tomorrow. If you're busy today, now I'll come to you tomorrow. Intaha darsu. Intaha yantahi is to come to an end. So the lesson has come to an end. That is a fa'il here. So again, we know this is fa is your coming as an ataf. It is not as a jawab al-shart. So we should not be confused. So whosoever arada. So here that is your fa'il, which is form 4. Arada yuridu. Mabniun ala fatha fi mahalli jazmin. So whosoever. So we know arada will have master mawal coming most of the time as a mafoolun bihi. So here we have ay yakhruja. So whosoever wants to go out. So again, see, this lam is lam amr. So we know whenever it is lam amr, that means it is talabiyah. So do we need fa? Yes, we need fa. So how do we say? So now we know that whenever the fa or waw comes in front of lam amr, this kasra changes into sukoon. So how do we say then? So fa man arada an yakhruja fal yakhruj. So he should go or let him go. Whosoever wants to go, he should go. In ta'ti sa'at al-ashirata tajidni fil bayti insha'Allah. So do we have to have fa here? So we need to see. In ta'ti. So if you come, ata ya'ti, to come, sa'at al-ashirata, at 10 o'clock. So if you come to me at 10 o'clock, tajidni. So do we need fa here? We need to see. It is not talab, it is fa'al mudariya, majzum is a natural condition. So we don't need fa. So what does it mean? You will find me fil bayti insha'Allah. You will find me in house insha'Allah. Allah wills. Mahma taqulli. So whatever you tell me. So lan has come. So do we need fa? So yes, we need fa. So then how do we say? We say fa lan. So then I will not. Usaddiqaka. So what is saddaqa? Yusaddiqu is to believe. Usaddiqu is I believe. So lan usaddiqa is I will not believe you. So whatever you tell me, I will not believe you. In anjahu. See, najaha yanjahu anjah. If I am successful, bi taqdiri mumtazin, in the excellent grade. So now we see, one a is your harful istifam, and the second ahsulu. Hasala yahsulu, that is the part of the fa'al. So do we need to bring fa? Yes, we need to bring fa because it is talab, it is istifam. We are asking question using fa'al. So what happens? Where do we put fa here? Do we put fa before the hamza or after the hamza? So we know this is a Queen Victoria. It won't let anybody come in front of her. So it has to be after hamzatul qata. So it will be ala jaizatin. Do I get a reward? So if I pass in excellent grade. In takun musta'jilan. So again, if you are, so you are what? Istajala is the one has to, he's busy, or is he's in a hurry. So ajala is to be, to haste, or if he's in a hurry. If you are in hurry, lastu has come. So laisa. So then do we need fa? So we need to think, yes, we need fa, because it is laisa, it is jamin. So how do we say? Falastu. If you are in a hurry, falastu musta'jilan. I am not in a hurry. In tarahu sahihan. So again, say in tara. Is it majzoom? Yes, it is majzoom because it is ra'a yara. So it is yara. So then we know it for the constant use becomes yara. And how do we make majzoom? Is hazafi harfi illa. So if you see it sahihan, correct. If you see that thing as correct. So we got to ma. Ma, it is harfu nafi here. Do we need fa? Yes. So how do we say? Fama arahu sahihan. So I don't see it right. You might be seeing it is right, but I don't see it right. So this sentence can be confusing. So we need to understand what is coming here. So ma ansa. Here if you see ma following with a fa'al, which is majzoom bi hazfi harfi illa. So this ma, it becomes ismu shart. So we know ma al-istifham and ma al-nafi, they won't have any effect on the fa'al. But when we see it is majzoom, so that means it's ismu shart. And how do we translate? We should immediately translate it as whatsoever. Ansa, what is nasiya yansa? Ansa is I forget. So whatever I forget, la ansa. So now again we need to understand what type of la is this. So we know when la comes and it is followed by fa'al, majzoom. So here we are seeing a fa'al which is majzoom, but is this la an nahiya? We need to understand. So we need to know that la an nahiya is only in the second and third person. So what do we have here? So we have ansa, which is first person. So we cannot forbid ourselves using la an nahiya. What type of la is this? This is la an nafiya. La an nafiya. So, but why is this majzoom? It's because it is coming as a jawabu shart. So do we have to bring fa here? So no, we don't need to bring fa because it is fa'al mudariya majzoom. It is in natural condition because of jawabu shart. So this is what we need to remember. It could be a confusing sentence here. So what do we translate? Whatever I forget, I will not forget zakal mansara, that scenario, that scene. In yas alka. See, in harfu shart, jazimun tajzimu fi alayni, yas al, it is in its natural condition. So if, so ahadun is your fa'il. So if anyone asks you, anni, so we know sa'ala always comes with an. So if anybody asks you about me, qul, what is it? Is it fa'il mudariya? Is it fa'il amr? It is fa'il amr because you're commanding. So it's a talab. So do we need fa? Yes, we need fa. So how do we say it? Faqul. Faqul. So that will be a right way of saying. Faqul lahu ana indal mudir. So if anybody asks you about me, so say him that I am with the mudir, with the head teacher. Man yurid hadal kitab. So whosoever wants this book. So again, huwa indal mudir. So what is huwa indal mudir? What type of jumla is this? It is jumlatul ismiya. Do we need fa? So yes. So how do we say? Fahuwa indal mudir. That's the right way of saying. So it is with the head teacher.
إِذَا سَعَلَنِ الْمُدِيرُ عَنْكَ مَاذَا قُولُ لَهُ.
So let's see. إِذَا, again it is إِسْمُ شَرْط غَيْرُ جَازِمٍ. So again Dr. Abdurrahim tries to test us. So he throws us ism, which is غَيْرُ جَازِمٍ. So it doesn't make majzum, so we don't have to worry whether it is فِي مَحَلِّ جَازِمٍ. So but it does relate about future. So it comes with فَعَلْ مَاذِي, but it tells about future. So if or when, إِذَا سَأَلَنِي الْمُدِيرُ, if the mudir asks me, عَنْكَ, about you. So again, مَاذَا is the form, that is طَلَب. So what do we say? فَمَاذَا. So we have to bring فَ. So what should I say him? فَمَاذَا أَقُولُ لَهُ, what should I say him? Number 16, يَدْرُسُ بِالْجَامِعَةِ الْإِسْلَامِيَّةِ طُلَّابٌ مِّن جَمْعِي أَنْحَاءِ الْعَالَمِ. In the Islamic University, students are studying. How do we translate? So first you go to the fa'il, طُلَّابٌ, and there is a مِّن جَمْعِي أَنْحَاءِ الْعَالَمِ. It is kind of a, not you can say. So the students from all over the world studying in the Islamic University. This is how you would translate. It is not word by word straight translation, so we need to get fa'il, fa'il and maf'ulun bihi. Faman, again this fa is not for the shart, it is for coming as a ataf or beginning of a sentence, but it's connected to the previous what has been mentioned. So faman darrasa fiha, so whosoever has studied in it, ka'annama, so ka'annama has come. Do we need fa? Yes, we need fa. So that fa is al waqiyatu li jawabi shart. فَكَأَنَّمَا, it is as if or it is as though, دَرَسَ, he studied, فِي جَامِعَاتِ كَثِيرَةٍ, it is as though he studied in many universities, because the subject is so vast, it is as though you studied in so many universities. So مَنْ يَقُلْ هَذَا الْكَلَامِ, so إِنَّ has come. So we know إِنَّ, it is, we have learned about مُبْتَدَى and خَبَر, it is a جُمْلَةُ الْإِسْمِيَة. So do we need فَ? Yes, we need fa. So we have, how do we say? مَنْ يَقُلْ هَذَا الْكَلَامِ, whosoever has said this, فَإِنَّهُ جَاهِلٌ, and he is truly ignorant. جَاهِل means ignorant. مَا تَزْرَ تَحْسُد, so what does it mean? So whatever you sow, زَرَ يَزْرَعُ, so مَا تَزْرَ, whatsoever you sow, تَحْسُد, حَسَدَ يَحْسُدُ, is to reap. So whatever you sow, you reap. So do we need ma here? So no, because both the fa'ils, they are in their natural condition. So they don't meet any of the seven conditions. In tazurni, saufa has come. So if you visit me, do we need fa? Yes, we need fa. So we say, fa saufa azuruka. Zara yazuru azur. So moving forward, we'll go to the last sentence of this class, inshallah, which says, man yastaghfir Allah يَغْفِرْ لَهُ. So we're looking to each word here. What does it mean? So we know مَنْ إِسْمُ شَرْطٍ جَازِمٌ تَجْزِمُ فِي أَلَيْنِ, and where is the فعل شرط? It is يَسْتَغْفِرْ with سُكُون. So why do we have كَسْرَ? It's for the phonetic. So whenever we have a فعل with كَسْرَ, so we should realize that it is a مَجْزُوم form, because the كَسْرَ is only for the phonetics. The فعل never takes a كَسْرَ. So what form is this? This is form 10. So إِسْتَغْفَرَ. So we have been mentioning before, whenever we have ista, that means a person does from its own will. So istaghfara is to seek forgiveness. Forgiveness from whom? Is Allah. The lafzul jalala is the maf'ulun bihi. So we need to be very careful. We should never say yastaghfirullahu, istaghfirullah na'uz billah, which means Allah seeks forgiveness. So this has to be yastaghfirullaha. So whosoever. So where is the fa'il here? Fa'il mustatir taqdiruhu huwa yadullu ala man. So whosoever seeks forgiveness from Allah. So do we need fa' here? Sorry. Yaghfir. So yaghfir is in its natural majzoom form. It is not a talab. It is not a amr. It is not a nahi. It is fa'il mudari' majzoom. So because of man. So we don't need fa' here. So we just say yaghfir lahu. So here, what is the fa'il here? Here again, فاعل مصدر تقديره هو يدل على الله. So he forgives him. So whosoever seeks forgiveness from Allah, يغفر له, he forgives him. That brings to the end of class 51. It's a bit long lesson. It's a very, very important lesson. So we're going very slowly so that everybody can absorb this concept of shart, fa'al shart, jawab shart, and how should we interject fa and when we should interject fa, inshallah. So we'll continue with more exercise in our next class. Until then, keep practicing and keep watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.